published 1226 est the 8th of January 2018, updated 1250 est the 8th of January the 2018. It's a stunning image of the rings of Saturn with an unexpected photobombs. The latest images from the Naudid Cassini spacecraft released by NASA have revealed an unexpected peek at its smallest moon, Saturn's tiny moon Pan, about 17 miles, 28 kilometers across, is seen between its icy rings. Scroll down for video. Saturn's tiny moon Pan, about 17 miles, 28 kilometers across, orbits within the Encke gap in the A ring. Beyond, we can see the arc of Saturn itself, its cloud tops streaked with dark shadows cast by the rings. Moons of Saturn were originally named for Greco-Roman Titans and descendants of the Titans, but as many new moons were discovered, scientists began selecting names from more mythologies, including Gaelic, Inuit and Norse stories. Pan, a satyr, a creature resembling a man with the hind legs and hooves of a goat, is a Greek god of nature and the forest. Saturn's tiny moon Pan, about 17 miles, 28 kilometers across, orbits within the Encke gap in the A ring. Beyond, we can see the arc of Saturn itself, its cloud tops streaked with dark shadows cast by the rings. This image was taken in visible light with the Cassini spacecraft narrow-angle camera on February 12, 2016, at a distance of approximately 746,000 miles 1.2 million kilometers from Pan. Pan, the innermost of Saturn's known moons, has a mean radius of 8.8 miles 14.1 kilometers and orbits 83,000 miles 134,000 kilometers away from Saturn, within the Encke gap of Saturn's ring. Like Saturn's moon Atlas, it has a prominent equatorial ridge that gives it a distinctive flying saucer shape. As it orbits Saturn every 13.8 hours, it acts as a shepherd moon and is responsible for keeping the Encke gap open. The gap is a 200-mile, 325 kilometers opening in Saturn's A ring. Pan creates stripes, called wakes, in the ring material on either side of it. Since ring particles closer to Saturn than Pan move faster in their orbits, these particles pass the Moon and receive a gravitational kick from Pan as they do. The Cassini spacecraft ended its mission on September 15, 2017. The Cassini mission is a cooperative project of NASA, ESA, the European Space Agency and the Italian Space Agency. The Jet Propulsion Laboratory, a division of the California Institute of Technology in Pasadena, manages the mission for NASA's Science Mission Directorate, Washington. The Cassini orbiter and its two onboard cameras were designed, developed and assembled at JPL. The Imaging Operations Center is based at the Space Science Institute in Boulder, Colorado. It is a stunning, almost ghostly view of Saturn's moon. NASA has revealed the incredible image, taken by the Cassini probe, before it crashed into Saturn's atmosphere in a death dive. Although the probe has now been destroyed, NASA is still regularly releasing images from its mission. Scroll down for video. The new image shows Saturn's moon Enceladus drifting before the rings, which glow brightly in the sunlight. Just visible at the moon's south pole at bottom here is the plume of water, ice particles and other material that constantly spews from that ocean via fractures in the ice. Enceladus is Saturn's sixth largest moon, at 313 miles wide, 504 kilometers. Cassini observations have revealed hydrothermal activity, with vents spewing water vapor and ice particles out from a global ocean buried beneath the icy crust. According to NASA, the plume includes organic compounds, volatile gases, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, salts, and silica. And Cassini recently discovered hydrogen gas, said to be the missing ingredient for life. While it may look inhospitable like Saturn's other moons, the observations now it may have the elements needed to support life. Saturn's moon Enceladus drifts before the rings, which glow brightly in the sunlight, NASA said. Beneath its icy exterior shell, Enceladus hides a global ocean of liquid water, and many believe the planet could even hold life at its vast ocean. Just visible at the moon's south pole at bottom here is the plume of water, ice particles and other material that constantly spews from that ocean via fractures in the ice. The bright speck to the right of Enceladus is a distant star. This image was taken in visible light with the Cassini spacecraft narrow-angle camera on November 6, 2011, at a distance of approximately 90,000 miles 145,000 kilometers from Enceladus. The Cassini spacecraft ended its mission on September 15, 2017. The Cassini spacecraft ended its mission on September 15, 2017, and NASA has been releasing images from it regularly. Last month, it revealed a stunning compilation of death shots taken just before the probe crashed into Saturn. The brightly lit limb of a crescent Enceladus looks ethereal against the blackness of space, NASA says of one of the most impressive images. The rest of the Moon, lit by light reflected from Saturn, presents a ghostly appearance. NASA has revealed the incredible image, taken by the Cassini probe before it crashed into Saturn's atmosphere in a death dive. Enceladus, 313 miles or 504 kilometers across, is backlit in this image, as is apparent by the thin crescent. Enceladus, 313 miles or 504 kilometers across, is backlit in this image, as is apparent by the thin crescent. However, the Sun-Enceladus spacecraft's phase angle, at 141 degrees, is too low to make the Moon's famous plumes easily visible. This view looks toward the Saturn-facing hemisphere of Enceladus. The above image is a composite of images taken with the Cassini spacecraft narrow-angle camera on March 29, 2017, using filters that allow infrared, green, and ultraviolet light. Researchers have spotted plumes from the Moon's vast underground ocean. According to Dr. Postberg, the rock core of Enceladus is probably porous, which is why the water from the overlying ocean is able to deeply permeate it. At the same time, strong tidal forces from Saturn affect the loose rock in the Moon's core. The new computer simulations show that the frictional heat is transferred very efficiently to the water circulating through the core, heating it to more than 90 degrees Celsius. This water dissolves some constituents of the rocky material. At certain hotspots, the hydrothermal fluids vent back into the ocean. Due to the cooling, dissolved material now partially precipitates as fine particles, which are carried by the warm water to the ocean's surface. The hotspots are located primarily at the poles of Enceladus. The ascending hydrothermal fluids probably trigger local melting in the ice layer of the polar region. According to Dr. Postberg, this explains why the ice layer at the poles is considerably thinner than at the equator, 3 to 10 kilometers versus 35 kilometers. The view was obtained at a distance of approximately 110,000 miles, 180,000 kilometers from Enceladus. Image scale is 0.6 miles, 1 kilometer per pixel. More than a week after its dramatic death dive into Saturn's atmosphere, NASA has released Cassini's final images, revealing stunning last looks at the ringed planet and its mysterious moons. From a view of Enceladus setting behind Saturn, to the site where Cassini would make its impact, the new images show just what the spacecraft observed leading up to its demise. Cassini circled the planet for 13 years, helping to transform our understanding of the gas giant, and, thanks to its observations, scientists now know two of its moons have potential to host simple life. From a view of Enceladus setting behind Saturn, to the site where Cassini would make its impact, the new images show just what the spacecraft observed leading up to its demise. Its last image, pictured, is a monochrome look towards Saturn's nightside, light by sunlight reflected from the planet's rings and the breathtaking series of photos. NASA shows some of Cassini's final observations. Its last image, the space agency reveals, is a monochrome look towards Saturn's nightside, light by sunlight reflected from the planet's rings. There, Cassini entered Saturn's atmosphere just hours later, to embark on its mission-ending plunge. The spacecraft also captured detailed images of Saturn's rings, even revealing a look at the small moon Daphnis and the waves it causes in the Keeler Gap. In photo, a lone propeller can be seen. Space enthusiast Jason Major used some of Cassini's final images to stitch together a stunning composite of Saturn pictured as Cassini began its final dive toward the planet. The spacecraft also captured detailed images of Saturn's rings, even revealing a look at the small moon Daphnis and the waves it causes in the Keeler Gap, as seen above. The image was captured on September the 13th. These are the features created by small moonlets in the rings, as they attempt to open gaps in the ring material. According to NASA, space enthusiast Jason Major used some of Cassini's final images to stitch together a stunning composite of Saturn as Cassini began its final dive toward the planet. Here's a mosaic of Saturn made from raw images acquired by Cassini on September 13, 2017, as it was on its way toward its dive into the planet's atmosphere, he said in a post on Flickr. These images are uncalibrated for color but were acquired in visible light RGB filters. A week after its dramatic death dive into Saturn's atmosphere, NASA has released Cassini's final images, revealing stunning last looks at the ringed planet and its mysterious moons. Its last look at the giant moon Titan, on September 13, is shown. Cassini circled the planet for 13 years, helping to transform our understanding of the gas giant, and, thanks to its observations, scientists now know two of its moons have potential to host simple life. One of these is the icy moon Enceladus, seen setting behind Saturn in the image above. The Cassini spacecraft may be gone, but the remarkable observations gathered over the craft's 13-year mission will continue to reveal new insights on Saturn and the mysterious worlds orbiting it for some time to come. Just days after the dramatic conclusion to the craft's mission, NASA released a stunning Cassini observation of the planet's yin and yang moon, Iapetus. The photo is one of Cassini's last looks at the 914-mile-wide moon, revealing the striking dichotomy of its surface. Long known to be bright on one side and dark on the other, the strange moon is Saturn's third-largest satellite. In photo, a lone propeller can be seen pictured. These are the features created by small moonlets in the rings, as they attempt to open gaps in the ring material. According to NASA, Cassini launched from Cape Canaveral, Florida in 1997, then spent 7 years in transit followed by 13 years orbiting Saturn. In 2000 it spent 6 months studying Jupiter before reaching Saturn in 2004. In that time, it discovered six more moons around Saturn, three-dimensional structures towering above Saturn's rings, and a giant storm that raged across the planet for nearly a year. On 13 December 2004 it made its first flyby of Saturn's moons Titan and Dione. On 24 December it released the European Space Agency-built Huygens probe on Saturn's moon Titan to study its atmosphere and surface composition. There it discovered eerie hydrocarbon lakes made from ethane and methane. In 2008, Cassini completed its primary mission to explore the Saturn system and began its mission extension, the Cassini Equinox mission. In 2010 it began its second mission, Cassini Solstice mission, which lasted until it exploded in Saturn's atmosphere. In December 2011, Cassini obtained the highest resolution images of Saturn's moon Enceladus. In December of the following year, it tracked the transit of Venus to test the feasibility of observing planets outside our solar system. In March 2013, Cassini made the last flyby of Saturn's moon Rhea and measured its internal structure and gravitational pull. In July of that year, Cassini captured a blacklit Saturn to examine the rings in fine detail and also captured an image of Earth. In April of this year it completed its closest flyby of Titan and started its grande finale orbit, which finished on September 15. The mission has changed the way we think of where life may have developed beyond our Earth, said Andrew Coates, head of the Planetary Science Group at Mullard Space Science Laboratory at University College London. As well as Mars, outer planet moons like Enceladus, Europa and even Titan are now top contenders for life elsewhere, he added. We've completely rewritten the textbooks about Saturn. This falsy color, farewell view combines individual frames captured with filters sensitive to ultraviolet, green, and infrared light, according to NASA, and looks toward the Saturn-facing hemisphere of Iapetus. For centuries, scientists have questioned Iapetus's unusual yin-yang appearance. But, thanks to Cassini, they may have solved the mystery of its contrasted surface. Cassini observations of Iapetus support the prevailing theory that led to the understanding that the dichotomy of the surface is due to a combination of infalling dust from outside of the moon followed by a migration of water ice from the darker, therefore warmer areas to the cold, brighter surfaces, NASA explains. In the breathtaking series of photos, NASA shows some of Cassini's final observations. This photo, captured on September 13, shows a stunning look at Saturn's rings. Cassini captured this last look at Iapetus on May 30, from roughly 1.5 million miles away. NASA's Cassini mission came to a bittersweet conclusion early Friday morning, as the historic spacecraft plunged into Saturn's atmosphere to become one with the gas giant planet it had studied for 13 years. As mission scientists said their farewells to the craft and prepared to examine its final observations, footage emerged of the dramatic moment Cassini first lifted off 20 years ago, to embark on its billion-mile trek to Saturn. The breathtaking footage takes us back to the Cape Canaveral launch pad on October 15, 1997, as mission control counts down to the start of a journey that brought an incredible wealth of discoveries. Just days after the dramatic conclusion to the craft's mission, NASA has released a stunning new observation of the planet's yin and yang moon, Iapetus. For centuries, scientists have questioned Iapetus's unusual yin-yang appearance. But, thanks to Cassini, they may have solved the mystery of its contrasted surface. The as mission scientists say their farewells to the craft and prepare to examine its final observations. Footage has emerged of the dramatic moment Cassini first lifted off 20 years ago to embark on its billion-mile trek to Saturn. Cassini launched in 1997 from Cape Canaveral Air Force Station in Florida, bringing it past Venus twice, Earth, and Jupiter on its way to Saturn. But, it would be many years, and a billion miles, before it reached its target. "We have cleared the tower, and the Cassini spacecraft is on its way to Saturn," Mission Control can be heard saying in the 20-year-old footage, as the rocket breaks through the clouds. The spacecraft arrived to Saturn in 2004, marking the start of its historic 13-year mission studying the planet and its moons. "This is the final chapter of an amazing mission, but it's also a new beginning," Thomas Zurbuchen, Associate Administrator for NASA's Science Mission Directorate at NASA headquarters in Washington, said as the space agency marked the end of Cassini's mission. "Cassini's discovery of ocean worlds at Titan and Enceladus changed everything, shaking our views to the core about surprising places to search for potential life beyond Earth." After 20 years in space, Cassini spacecraft finally completed its suicide mission at 756 AM ET Friday, plunging into Saturn's atmosphere. "While we were unable to see Cassini's dying moments, an animation released by NASA reconstructs the probe's last few minutes as it tumbled through Saturn's atmosphere at 77,000 mph. Cassini launched in 1997 from Cape Canaveral Air Force Station in Florida, bringing it past Venus twice, Earth, and Jupiter on its way to Saturn. But, it would be many years, and a billion miles, before it reached its target. "We have cleared the tower, and the Cassini spacecraft is on its way to Saturn," Mission Control can be heard saying in the 20-year-old footage, as the rocket breaks through the clouds. The Cassini operations team did an absolutely stellar job guiding the spacecraft to its noble end, said Earl Mays, Cassini project manager at JPL, from designing the trajectory 7 years ago, to navigating through the 22 nail-biting plunges between Saturn and its rings. "This is a shock group of scientists and engineers that scripted a fitting end to a great mission. What a way to go. Truly a blaze of glory." The confirmation of the mission was received at NASA's Jet Propulsion Unit at 0756 EST-1256 BST. Upon receiving the news, Earl Mays, program manager for Cassini, announced the signal from the spacecraft has gone. "Congratulations, this has been an incredible mission, an incredible spacecraft. After 20 years in space, NASA's Cassini spacecraft has finally completed its suicide mission, plunging into Saturn's atmosphere." The confirmation of the mission was received at NASA's Jet Propulsion Unit at 0756 EST-1256 BSTIN. "It's 13 years at Saturn and 2 decades in space. The $4 billion, £3 billion Cassini probe has transformed our understanding of the ring planet and its moons. It has watched giant storms on the gas giant, recorded its ring system in stunning detail, and revealed incredible new insights on the potential habitability of Saturn's moons. The decision to kill off Cassini was taken because the craft would soon run out of fuel and become impossible to steer. Scientists feared a collision with Titan or Enceladus, two of Saturn's moons that in the past 10 years have shown a potential to host simple life. NASA's animation imagine what the death dive would have looked like first. They expect the probe to have shed layers of insulating material. NASA's animation imagines what the death dive would have looked like. First, they expect the probe to have shed layers of insulating material. Saturn's active, ocean-bearing moon Enceladus sinks behind the giant planet in a farewell animation from NASA's Cassini spacecraft than its large external structures, including the 11-feet-wide dish antenna and 30-feet-long magnetometer boom, will have weakened and broken apart, followed by other body-mounted components, and eventually the leading face of the spacecraft itself. It is also possible that propellant left in Cassini's fuel tanks may have exploded. Meanwhile, atmospheric friction will have sent temperatures soaring. By the time what was left of Cassini reached the cloud tops, it would have been transformed into a glowing, fragmenting meteor, hotter than the surface of the sun. Project manager Earl Mays, Center, shakes hands with Bill Heventhal, left head of uplink operations in mission control at NASA's Jet Propulsion Lab. "Finally, intense heat and pressure would have caused every part of the spacecraft to melt and dissociate, scattering its atoms to the winds of Saturn. Cassini's death plunge was the climax of a grand finale that saw the probe slip between Saturn and its rings in 22 daring orbits. 15 minutes before the end, the voice of Dr. Mays could be heard in a live from Mission Control telling his team this might be a good time to pass out the farewell peanuts. Earlier, Jet Propulsion Laboratory Director Mike Watkins told a NASA interviewer, "It's kind of a bittersweet event for all of us. For me personally, it's more sweet than bitter, because Cassini has been such a fantastic mission." During the live feed, experts from NASA described the event as the last hour of the last chapter of Cassini's grand finale. Cassini science team members Nora Longaia, Scott Edgington C. and Joe Pitesky L. Hug as the final loss of signal from the Cassini spacecraft is confirmed.